Oh my gosh.
What's up, everybody? My name is Schuyler Diehm. I'm a lifestyle fat loss coach. We help our clients simplify the process of losing weight using fasting, mindfulness, and weightlifting. And today, we are diving into aspartame. And before diving into it today, if you are looking for more awesome ways to simplify getting healthy, tap that subscribe button. I do these videos for free, but if you're looking to tune in and this stuff interests you, I would love for you to be part of our community. Now, that being said, I have seen a lot of influencers, a lot of people talking about aspartame. Now, aspartame is the ingredient that's in diet soda. Particularly, the one that comes to mind is Diet Coke. And if you've been on the internet long enough, you may have seen that there's both sides of the argument. One side says if you have one sip of aspartame, you're going to die. And the other side says, hey, aspartame actually isn't bad. And so if you've been following my content, you know I'm a very holistic person, and you probably can guess I'm not a fan of aspartame. But what you hear a lot of people in the holistic space say is aspartame causes cancer, that it's terrible for you. And I do agree it's not great for you, but the study that showed that aspartame caused cancer was done on mice, and the mice were consuming way more aspartame in a ratio than humans potentially could in a day. So I don't necessarily think that that's a good argument for aspartame, but I do think aspartame is something that should be reduced if not avoided, and here's why. So I avoid aspartame at pretty much all costs just because I'm very, very intense with my health. Sucralose, on the other hand, which is an artificial sweetener, I'll have in my pre-workouts. I'll have in protein bars every now and again. It's not something I have consistently. It is something I try to avoid, but it's something where if I have it, I'm not gonna freak out about it. I'm not gonna feel bad about it. So what inspired this video? The other day I was browsing Instagram and I saw a fitness influencer who was almost at 1 million followers do a Q&A, and he was asked, is Diet Coke bad? Should it be avoided? You know, this guy's at almost 1 million followers, and his response was something along the lines of, you know, the research shows that it's not too bad, so have it whenever you want it. And while I think a lot of people tend to go on the other side of the spectrum of like, you're gonna die if you consume it, I still have a problem with people telling you that something like Diet Coke is okay. We live in a very fragile state where people rationalize, okay, if someone says it's okay and this guy's an influencer and he's in pretty good shape, then I can pretty much have it whenever I want. Whereas from my experience, from some clients I've worked with, and also just hearing this in general and doing the research, Diet Coke and aspartame in general can be extremely addictive, and it can also create some internal health issues along the way. So in my opinion, aspartame is something that should be regulated. It should be something that should not be had consistently, and here's why. So number one, let's think about our bodies from an evolutionary perspective, right? When your body consumes something with sugar, fruit juice, anything along those lines that's a natural food, it's gonna come with some other calories, it's gonna come with some other fibers, it's gonna come with all these other things. And so from an evolutionary perspective, if we're consuming something that is ultra sweet, and we're talking aspartame is 200 times sweeter than sugar, but we're not getting any calories, we're not getting any energy from it, you think there's gonna be a disconnect there? You think maybe your body's gonna go into overdrive to look for more food so that you can actually get calories from something sweet? And so what I've tend to see with my clients, and what I've heard from other people's perspectives, is that when they have diet soda consistently, their appetite skyrockets. They're always craving out more food. And I believe not only is this because, number one, it's 200 times sweeter than sugar, so probably alters your taste buds a little bit, probably lets you enjoy foods with actual real sugar like fruit even less, but then in the process it's also pushing you to crave out more food, to want to eat more in general. Another thing, so there was a study that came out, daily diet sodas increased risk for metabolic syndrome by 34%, and there's a 20% increased risk of heart attack. Now this is worth saying, this is probably correlation, not causation, meaning it may not be the sodas themselves, but people who are drinking soda are probably more likely to be having other unhealthy habits in their life, so there's probably an increase in that span. But it's something to think about, right? If the healthiest people on earth are avoiding sodas like these, there's probably a good reason. Another thing that kind of rubs me the wrong way is aspartame is made by distilling cheap ingredients like coal tar and methanol down. Looking at it from a perspective, it's probably not a healthy thing to consume those things, and if they're distilled down, it's potentially even less healthy. And then finally, I think the biggest thing that stands out for me is the companies that are producing foods with these ingredients, the Coca-Cola, all the other sodas out there, all the other places that use aspartame. In the past, they have tended to not be ethical companies. In the past, they have tended to use cheaper ingredients at the cost of our health. And so why would you promote a company like that? Why would you trust a company? Why would you want to consume their products if it's very obvious that they do not care about you in the slightest, that all they care about is finances, money. So in that case, if you're craving something sweet, why not have something from a company that cares about you? Or even better, why not have a real food like a fruit or a honey or something that's actually good for your body? And so I'm kind of throwing a lot at you here, and I'm going to wrap this all together in a second, but I'd be curious if you could leave me a comment. How often are you consuming artificial sweeteners right now? Whether it's the aspartame, sucralose in pre-workout, anything like that. I'd love to hear from you. So to wrap this all up, a couple key things here. Number one, I see artificial sweeteners as toxins. Now, as the evidence shows, they may not cause cancer directly, but we're living in a world where we are literally surrounded by toxins, from the things we cook in, the things we store our food in, the food itself, cleaning products, the clothes we wear. Literally, the more I look around, the more I learn about this stuff, the more I see how much toxins there actually are around us. And so if we're not regulating these toxins, our body's gonna do its best to push them out, but it may not be able to once you hit a certain threshold where you're consuming too much. And if you have that toxic buildup, that's when disease is gonna be created. That's when things like cancer, other potential issues like eczema, headaches, nausea, bloating, all this stuff can become an issue. And so if you're living in society, which if you're watching this, you are probably getting hit with a lot of toxins. So why would you expose yourself to another toxin? Why would you expose yourself to something like aspartame? I would rather be okay with being chill in a couple other areas, being okay with consuming toxins in a couple other areas, and do something like soda, which can easily be swapped out for other things. Now, that doesn't mean it's going to be easy itself. It's easy to swap it out. It's pretty difficult to stay consistent, especially because these ingredients can be so addicting. But what I would recommend if you are currently drinking aspartame is potentially switch back to regular soda, see how your body responds. But more importantly, start making the swap to better options. Choose sparkling waters, add your own ingredients like stevia or lemon or apple cider vinegar, things that are gonna help you enjoy the drink a little bit more than just having plain water, and also fill that hole of that habit whenever you grab a Diet Coke. There's also healthy alternate sodas out there. So Madvine is the one that I'm aware of. I know there's a couple other, but Madvine uses completely clean ingredients and it legit tastes like a Coke. But whatever you do, just start making swaps. It doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be immediately, but over time you're looking to improve, and that's a good way to start. Now, if you've been watching my content for a while, you know I'm also a major, major fan of fasting. Fasting can actually alter your taste buds, which can make it quicker to adapt off of things like aspartame. And so if you are curious what we do, if you're curious how to use fasting, make sure you check the link in the description. We've got our beginner's fasting guide there. Now, this guide is going to walk you through everything you need to know to start using fasting to lose weight, to boost your energy, to change your taste buds, and to just feel incredible in general. So with that being said, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like it, make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon to be notified when we release new videos, and also check the link in the description for our starters fasting guide. With that being said, of course, as always, make sure to eat smart, move more, sleep deep, and be grateful for this moment. I'll see you in the next video.